to Final Fantasy 14, A Realm Reborn Let's Play. Hey guys, I know it's a little, I'm in the middle of a actual quest. I will explain what I did later. Let's go ahead and finish the quest here real quick, and I will explain. Without further ado, welcome back. It seems you've wasted no time putting your skills to work. How do you know? Why, the recruitment officer called to regale me with the tale of your heroics. The pride in his voice was palatable. We Zalans are truly fortunate to have you with us, Mana. Now then, as we last spoke, I said that I wanted you to meet some friends. Did I not? Well, I neglected to mention that you have already met. Tataru, please show them in. This way, sirs. It's Biggs and Wedge. Thanks for getting us out of that mess. We owe you our lives.
But I don't think we properly introduced ourselves. I am Biggs.
And I'm... Gods, man, spit it out, will you? Wedge, at your service. A little over the top while they're in it. Okay. I am pleased to say that Biggs and Wedge are staying with us for a while. How long? And they can't have my room. Magitech-driven contraptions such as the airships grow ever more vital to the city-states of El Orzir. As a neutral party, it was judged that the Scions should serve as keepers of this technology. Of course, for this we need knowledgeable experts, and so we requested the assistance of the Garlon Ironworks, who's very kind of us to send two of their finest engineers. Our happy family continues to grow. On behalf of the Scions, I bid you welcome to the Waking Sands. Like every soul here, I love El Orzio. I count myself blessed when I have been given this chance to stand with you and all and fight for the future of the realm. I never know such fulfillment, such happiness. All right, cool. So that actually completed the quest we started last time. Man. All right, we're gonna go ahead and get started here, but I'm gonna pause the video because I've got to take care of some things, and I will be right back. All right, I'm terribly sorry about that, guys. Let's go ahead and do our introductions. I am Ophia, and as always, this is Mana, our Let's Play character. Unfortunately, I am coming down with probably a cold, so I've got a lot of sinus drainage and this nasty cough. Wow, I can't believe it. Okay, so we are here in the Waking Sands to find out what Minfila had to give us. And if you noticed, last time we saved the two Garlon engineers from being taken away by the Empire. Or imps for short, if you want to call them that. So, the Sylph management. Oh, I love this part. This is, not really. I'm lying. This is probably the most boring part of the series.
Now, having set aside the formalities, we have a favor to ask of you.
Oh, really?
Uriange, have the documents arrived from the students of Baldessian?
Aye, my lady. They arrived but recently.
We have conducted a study at the behest of the Order of the Twin Adder. Popolimo, Ida, a synopsis, if you would.
Make it short.
Our task was to survey the behavior of the Sylphs, a beast tribe indigenous to the Twelveswood.
You don't say.
Oh, how to describe them. They look like Gizzlegreens, floating ones, that worship the primal Ramu.
Gizzlegreens? Oh, Lord. Should I take my chocobo?
Though technically a beast tribe, Sylphs are blessed with a comparatively personable demeanor, conducive to peaceful communication.
Offering us an invaluable opportunity to learn what the beast tribes know of the primals.
While Ramu's existence is well documented, the Sylphs do not, or perhaps cannot, summon the primal any longer, insofar as can be ascertained. Until such time as we know, it would be unwise to assume that the threat posed by the primal has passed.
Which leaves Gridania with the added worry of not knowing what they should be worrying about.
In that regard, they are hardly alone. What we can say with absolute certainty is that Gridania has its hands full fending off Garuda. Who, I need hardly remind you, is among the most savage and terrible of all known primals.
In short, it is essential that we approach the Sylphs in as diplomatic a manner as possible. Words and actions can be misconstrued. The only sure way to communicate our intentions is the Echo.
Which is why I'm going.
Winning the Sylph's favor may well bring us a step closer to mitigating the threat of the primals. Will you help us?
Sure, why not? I'm always a sucker for an adventure.
I am grateful.
Lovely. Well, as much as I'd like to help, I'm afraid I would be of little use to anyone in Gridania. A veritable babe in the woods.
Oh, would you stop with the puns, please?
Ida and Papalimo, however, should be able to see the forest for the trees. Is that not so, Minfilia?
He doesn't stop. No, he does not stop.
Indeed. You are willing?
Leave it to me.
Us, Ida, us!
So Ida and Papalimo remind me of a bunch of cartoon characters. they do. I was like, wow, these guys are so... Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. I don't want to dwell on that too long. So we just completed Coin and Country. Oh, cool. And we're supposed to go to the Twin Adders in Gridania, but I'm going to make a pit stop real quick. Or... No, not pit stop. I don't think that's the term I want to use. I want to make a side trip real quick. Because I don't have to go to the bathroom or get any food or anything. So, we are now... I went and looked it up. The Chocobo quest should be available to us now. We just have to go grab him now. Cool. So what we got to do is we have to run down here. And I should have a quest at the Chocobo stables. And it don't look that way. Oh no. Oh no. Where's my Chocobo quest? Oh Lord. There must be another step to it. I have to go. I'll probably have to go look it up and just find out what else I need to do to get it. I do remember one time getting a Chocobo in Gridania. For some reason, I don't know. I have a quest here. But I think, I'm pretty sure this is just a quest for PvP. But let's see. No, it's My Little Chocobo. Okay. So this is the quest, My Little Chocobo. It actually gives you the Chocobo Whistle to call. And accept. Private Valfour, yes, a moment of your time, if you please. Wish to carry out your duties swiftly, do you not? Then, well, perhaps you should get yourself a Chocobo. I've been looking for one since day one. If you're interested, the Immortal Flames wish to furnish you one. It is not a complex process, but it does require some paperwork. First, speak to the quartermaster and obtain a Chocobo license. Sorry, a Flame Chocobo insurance. You'll need to exchange the company seals to do so. Once you have received your issue, show it to Mimigun by the gate of gates. No. Wow, I'm having a hard time today. And he will be one to furnish you with the bird. So, as I last said last time we of course I last said last time. Too many lasts. No, like I went over last time that I should have some. Yes, I already have my supply missions refurnished themselves. And like last time, I went over these and I did 2 pages of these, so I did 2 days worth of Chocobo. Sorry, I got Chocobo on the brain. I did 2 days worth of currencies and I have gotten, well, I had actually gotten 5,000 plus seals because I already got the Chocobo license or insurance. Sword, and what is right here? Chocobo insurance. Which you pick up from the Flame Master Quartermaster for 2,000 seals. So, actually, I probably could have done that before I finished that because I think that quest was sitting there the entire time. My bad. Could have had it before. I could have went ahead and got the Chocobo before I even went out to the Waking Sands and saved myself some backtracking. But I guess that was what happens when you don't read the quest guides all the way, right? Excuse me. Mimigun, I got something for you. I want a bird issued, he said. Then you need the Chocobo insurance. Here you go, good sir. Yes, everything appears to be in order. One moment, please. I'll be right back with your Chocobo. Here he is. This fellow is in high spirits, and the past few bells, he must have sensed his master was coming. Now then, make an official, and you want to give your noble steed a name. Whee! Where's he at? Oh, there he is. Oh, I'm having a problem with latency there. So, what should we name you, dude? Or you dudette? Well, I normally go with O'Neill. And you can't have it. That's why it always shows O'Neill. You can't have two, you can't have a first and last name. All right, O'Neill with the Wells. Onel. I dare say he likes the name. Here's your very own chuckable whistle. Simply blow it into, and your feathered friend will come bound to your side. But do forgive him if he doesn't respond when summoned in crowded cities, areas, monster-infested lairs. Chocobos are stout heart creatures, but they have their limits. And lastly, I present to you your Chocobo riding license as required by law. And that concludes the formalities. If you wish to, I wish you and your Chocobo long years of full companionship. Sweet, sweet, sweet. And I got my next level. I've got Provoke on my Gladiator, so guess what? I am going back over to Marauda. There we go. Nice, nice, nice. All right, so now we gotta go to the 12 Woods and Gordania. Oh, well, first things, let's go ahead and learn our Chocobo. Chocobos are pretty cool. We can actually, because we have, this isn't a brand new account, we actually have some actual, we have some actual bardings. You get the Behemoth Barding was from I can't remember if the Behemoth Barding was an actual, was actually a I'm drawing a blank here. Is it collector's edition of reward, or I know the Black Mage and the Barding of Light are subscription rewards for subscribing for X amount of time. So I'm not quite sure on the Behemoth Barding. I'm almost 100% sure it was part of the 2.0 collector's edition release. It could have been the pre-order reward. It could have been one of the pre-order rewards. I'm not, don't quote me on that. No, it's not a pre-order reward, because I'm not using my pre-order account. I managed to get a hold of my account information for my 1.0 account, and that's when I just decided to go with that instead. Although I had already bought the game the second time, I was able to upgrade to the collector's edition digitally. I did that with my 1.0 account. All right, we need to speak to the Serpent Commander. How's it going, dude? We know far too little of the Sylphs to lay any worthwhile plans, and we must call upon the Scions for more. Oh, beg your pardon, that's just a terrible habit of mine to think aloud. But tell me, what brings you here to the Adder's Nest? Actually, I'm with the Scions. Hey, old adventurer, I bid thee welcome to the Adder's Nest. Do you seek to entwine your destiny with the Twin Adder? Good evening, Commander. Sorry to disappoint you, but other business brings us here. Ida, Papalimo, always a pleasure to see you too. My men tell me you quest the name of the Scions of Late. Quest in the name of the Scions of Late. Quite so, Commander. A little bird told us that the Twin Adder was in need of adventurous prowess. Aye, your bird sings true. No doubt you've heard that we're investigating these Sylphs. That curious beast tribe, it calls the depths the 12 Woods to home. Sylphs are, for the most part, peaceable bunch, much to the delight of the Elder Seeds. Who has no desire to see her people embroiled yet another fruitless war. And the Twin Adder isn't the same mind. Tis
precisely the reason why the Sylph's relation to the primal Ruhumat has risen a flag of warning amongst our ranks. Friendly as they may appear, beastmen will be beastmen. And should there be even a sliver of chance of summoning the primal, might disturb the balance between Gardania and the Sylph's tribes. It is possibly a possibility we can ignore. Better to be safe than sorry, indeed. Do we strike at Ruhumat and leave the Sylphs to their own ways? That is the question, yet I find myself lacking ample knowledge to arrive at its answer. Opinions abound with Gardania, but to listen to one's own is among the greatest mistakes a commander can make. I would hear from the other side, Sylphs themselves, and seek an impartial party to serve as my liaison. That is where you Scions come in. Of course. The Scions of Little the Sylphs of Little Solace remain untempered and have held many a productive dialogue with our people. I would hear their candid thoughts on the tempered brethren. That said, I urge you to exercise due caution. Sylph tradition and etiquette bears a little resemblance to our own and would not have had any cross-cultural luck. Wow, that's a word I don't know. Lux pass? Flukas? Get in the way of our productive parlay. In other words, don't screw it up. En route to Little Solace, you will come upon Hawthorne's hut. Our officer stationed there can enlighten you as to how to win the Sylph's favor. May your expedition be worthwhile. A worthwhile one. A friend, our friendly favor with the Sylphs. This should be a pleasant enough diversion. The Hawthorne Hut, was it? Why do I believe the ferry departed from West Shore Pier should take us there? Friendly paver indeed. I hope this will be straightforward as you say, Papalimo. Oy, oy, oy. Man, I just can't get some of this dialogue sometime. Man, this cold is kicking my butt. Going to these coughing fits and this sinus drainage. Give me some Benadryl. Hopefully that will affect some of this sinus drainage that's going on and alleviate some of this cough. Alright, now we have to go speak with the Sylph. We come in peace. That's an interesting title. Come on, move it. Oh wow, we gotta speak to the guard here. Why do I have to speak to the guard? I know where to go. I, the ferry docked at the base, will carry you across the lake to the east shore. East route, I'm sorry. Once you're ashore, head due east, and you should find Hawthorne's hut without much trouble. The Hawthorns are our most welcoming folk. We should have no small measure of goodwill. Still, a bit courtesy goes a long way. I would encourage you to stop by the Full Flower Calm and introduce yourself to Rosa before you travel on.
Man, I hope this. Whew! This is killing me. I might have to. May have to end up stopping a video short here if I can't get this sinus thing under control. Alright, guess what time it is? Yes, it's time to pull out our buddy. And let's go with the fat chickabo. I have not seen it. That is funny. I like it. I seen it with my old character, but nah, I hadn't seen it with my new one. That is cool. You look good. You're hanging a Gazel Greener in front of his face. Running board. Here's Rosa. Hey, Rosa, how's it going? I gotta stop this stampeding chocobo. Rosa, what's up? Wow. An adventurer, thanks to 12. You could have not come at a more opportune time. Please help me. You must. Why are bees? The poor little deers are under attack by a murderous swarm of hornets. These bees are a livelihood. You must save them. Oh no. Not the... What am I gonna do with the hornets? Anybody got some raid? Who knew you can kill hornets? A swarm of hornets with an axe. Yeah, the thought of unbelievable comes to mind here. But, at least in Final Fantasy XI, the hornets were was one big hornet, so that was actually a little bit more feasible. But a swarm of small hornets, I don't know. I really can't tell about that, but I don't think that is possible. They would probably sting me to death before I could kill them. Oh man, at least you know if the adventure thing don't work out, you can always go into actual pest control. Yeah. Nice. Hey, okay. Your work has been done for you. Where is her? Sorry. I did your work for you. Oh, thank you, friend. Finally, our bees can make their own make their honey in peace. I knew you were 12 cent the moment I laid eyes on you. You're traveling to our hut, you say, and would speak with the serpent officer there. There's no one who goes by the name goes by Alamillion. I'm sorry, there is one who goes by Amelaine, and he is a sentry at Jocelyn's Spire, but makes regular incursions to our hut, quite enamored of our honey and tales of my husband. Though I have found him to be tight-lipped around those he's unfamiliar with. Oh, I know what we might try. Why not take a jar of fresh honey to him? I reckon you'll find him a little bit more talkative then. Okay. Alright, let's go here. And, where is it at? There's a skill. Oh yeah, it's a skill you can actually put on your hotbar. Yeah, Mount Roulette. In other words, it will cycle through the actual mounts. So let's see what we get. A fat chocobo. Okay, we'll go with that. Nice. I hadn't heard the music for this yet. He's running like he ain't got no ankles. That was great. That's pure comedy, I guess. Hey, what's up, dude? I got some honey for you. You know what I mean? Indeed, I am Emlyn of the Twin Atta. Your face is unfamiliar to me. You have a present for me, you say? A jar of roses honey. Freshly harvested to boot. You certainly know how to make a first impression, friend. You are the adventurer who came, whom the commander spoke of. Do forgive me for being curt. My stomach was rumbling something fierce. My words, this honey is like liquid gold. Forgive me. You have come to discuss not honey but sylphs. For all the wisdom that they are not worried a worry lot. Particularly since the Empire has come to the Shroud. They're earned their trust, how, and they will, and they're as friendly as any folk. They have quirks, but so do we, not all. What would you do? What would you know more? Would you want, my God. Would you know more? You'd do well to speak to Rosa's husband here, Raphael. He forgot more about the sylphs than I ever knew. Interesting. Nice. And we got a level on Marauder. Oh my God, we are leveling up all over the place. That's the one thing I hate about the controller. It's a fight to do anything. Alright, we got that set. Should have done that off camera. But, anyways. Rofel. Oh, damn, my finger's fat. Sorry, I beg your pardon, friend. My memory just not what it used to be. I've seen so much more in my adventuring days, and it's all cluttered in my noggin now. Though I share my stories with those around the hut before, you might have more luck with them. Interesting. So now we gotta question everybody else who has talked to him to see if they know anything. Sylphs, yes, father told me about the stories plenty of times. What I've found the most captivating is their concept of etiquette was most completely alien to our own. And you'd do best not to underestimate them on account of their childlike looks. Your face end up in a mess of glyphs. Oh, facing up a mess of glyphy snuggles and chokeable scratches. Eww. That don't sound any good. So we got to talk to a couple guys outside. You've been speaking to the old man? Blasset. Quickest way to a quiver woman's heart might be through her stomach, but don't even think of trying those oust on your food stuff on a sylph. They sustain themselves simply by bathing in sun, or so Rorfo once told me. The sylphs. The inner veteran tricksters and troublemakers, that's what they are. One day they draw a marble face, a mask, and the next day they're sending our young sentries falling from the bottom of a ravine. What? Tell them to stop and they just laugh at you. Rofu claims that they harbor no ill will, but I dare say pranks are no laughing matter. Sound like an interesting bunch. Sound like a guy I knew in college. Oh, of course. Hearing your stories, well, my stories, brought back memories flooding back to me. I feel like dancing. Fabulous.
Yes, nothing brings people together quite like a toe tapping. A sylph told me long ago that dancing is more time-honored greeting among their kind. You'd do well to remember this. This may just help win favor of our forest friends. Thank you, Zah. Oh, you got another one. Oh, so here. Great, there's one more thing you should know about this sylphs. They don't take kindly to guests who show up empty-handed. To earn a sylph's trust, you'd do well to bring along drive. What was it again? Rose and I was just speaking of the matter not days ago. Forgive me, friend. Speak to Rosa at the column, and her memory should prove more reliable than mine. Wow. He is going senile. Let's go roulette. Oh, we got a mount. We got a griffin. I don't know if I just got this turned down low or what. That's better. You know what'd probably do me better is put my headphones on, wouldn't it? Hang on a second, I'm gonna put my headphones on. Oh. Oh, yeah, much better. A peace offering is for the sylphs. I'd give you another jar of honey, but I fear that wouldn't get past the front door, dear. No, their taste runs more unusual. Your chance familiar with mook root. Milk root. That's what we call it. A root of the most finest Phoenix seed kin, the Uchi. And then chew it and it excludes a cloudy liquid that's said to induce curious visions of, wow, the hallucination of Limber. You did not catch me dead trying to stuff, but the sylph seems to enjoy it to no end. I've not seen an Uchi around the comb for quite some time, but did encounter such a suspicious clump of grass the other day. Were you to stimulate it somehow with something of this amber syrup, for example, you might be able to surprised what comes out. Good luck. Interesting. So, gotta go back to Rafi. Man, all this running around. Oh, you're back. Was my wife able to direct you for a suitable offering? Yeah, he said bring this. Milk root. Oh, but of course the sifts. Quaffle at the cloudy stuff as quick as I do a flagon of mead. The effects is just about the same as well. Any road, a gift of milk will have the sylphs calling you friend and sister of the moment. They lay eyes on it. Now, let me wrap it up for you. I'm starting to feel a bit woozy. Interesting. Alright, so we get to go speak to the sylphs.
First contact. I've taken the liberty of wrapping the milk root well and good. This should keep it nice and fresh, not to mention spare you from the god-awful stench. Yes, yes, can't do with the stench. The sylph loves the stuff, but me, I'd rather bury my nose in chocobo dung. I dare say it reeks even rivals the breath of a Marlboro. That put an end to my adventuring days. But I can't tell you the story. I can tell you that story another time. I've more important matters to attend to today. Yes, the sylph are an eccentric bunch, but I share their company enough to know that they're kind-hearted. Not to shun one whose intents are true. May your parley be a fruitful one, friend, and do stop on your way back on your return. There's a flagon of flower, a full flower mead with your name on it. Do you regale me with your adventure tales? And afore I forget, don't go traipsing off yet. Amelin is here, would have a word with you, travel and safety, friend, and do pass along my regards to the winged ones. Cool. Alright, I gotta speak to this guy. It's good to see you know your it's good to see your knowledge of the sylph culture has matured. I see no reason to delay your mission any further. Upon arrival at Little Solace, seek out a young sylph net by the name of Comaloxo. He served as an intermediary between our peoples on many occasions and has the ear of the of his tribe's elder. I see that Hawthorne has furnished you with some of that malabarous root, the sylphs of the door. I have something of far greater importance for you to deliver, a missive from the Elder Seed herself. To summarize the letter and its contents in brief, it vouches for the integrity of our envoy and that you would be, and restates Gardania's desire to maintain a harmonious relationship with our long-standing friends of the forest. The war with the Luxon Ixil has taken our toll on our resources, and we can ill afford to get mired in another conflict. I need not press upon you any other further importance of the mission. May the 12C return with good tidings. Lord. Alright, let's do the chocobo. I have to say, that does look like a cool mount. I hardly ever use this mount. Starting to like it though. And this is Little Solace. And we're Little Solace. The music here. Oh yes. I love the dialogue here is even worst one I have ever seen. Walking one's not familiar to this one. This one does not trust strange walking ones. Strange dancing ones might be a different story, but this expects no such thing. Walking one should go home and leave this place. And leave this one be. Oh man, I love it. Now you gotta dance. Where's my dance? There it is. I love it. Alright, you talk to me now? This one would welcome a walking one who moves like this one.
If Walking One would talk to this one, this one will answer. This one is a busy one, so Walking One should speak quick tongue. What the hell? Oh my god, that's crazy. Walking One bring gift to this one? Walking One is most kind. Walking One brings milk root. Milk root fills this one with joy. Great joy, I'm sorry. This one gives thanks. Many gives many, many, many thanks. Walking One carries message for Elder One. This one deliver message when Elder One to Elder One. Walking One should not worry. Hello there. We're the envoys from Gondania, and we're here to treat you. We're here to treat with your people. Aye, we've come to pay our respects to your elder and learn from him more of your Lord Rumut. Who are these ones? These Walking Ones came from Gondania. Walking Ones became a dancing one and brought milk root, but Walking One tricks this one does not like tricks. This one will speak no more. Elder One is busy. Walking One should go home. Go home, you say? But the sylphs of Little Solace has always welcomed Gondanian's envoys with open wings. And a letter carried by Mana here is an oath of peace penned by the Elder Seed herself. Still, you would refuse us? This one's reasons are no business of Walking Ones. Elder One has no words for Gondanians. Walking Ones waste everyone's time. Well, I never. Turned away at the gates? What do we do to deserve such a rude welcome? Was Manus Jig insufficient jiggling? That's a good one. I am as baffled as you, but something tells me recent events have our erdwast fluttering friends feeling uncommonly wayward. It would seem that we have no choice but to ask around and see what might earn their trust. Yay, it means I'm gonna have to dance for everyone. Dance party! Oh, Ida. I got it, Ida. Take your top off. That'll work. Mana, you're in the mood for dancing. I don't know, Ida. Are you? That's right, dancing. We went through a lot of trouble to learn Sylph's traditions, greetings, but you have greeted hardly any of them. While you're at it, why not dance for the Gondanians around here as well? Why, if I were a sylph, I'd be beside myself with delight to see an adventurer sharing my culture with their own kind and... Me? Of course I'll be happy to join. Oh, there goes my blood. Leg cramp in my... Oh my god. She's faking it. Oh my god. You... Alright, I'm gonna put... faking it. Where is that? Dance. I know it's here. That in the hot bar. I'm gonna do it quite a many times. Ooh, Walking One knows Jolly Dance. Jolly Dance fills this one with good cheer. Let these two be friends. Hey, guess what?
Zashinus? That's some fine dancing, friend. Why, if you weren't half as tall, if you were half as tall and twice as green, I might have mistaken you for a sylph myself. Any road, the sylphs are a peaceful folk. Approach them with an open mind and heart, and they'll open up to you in turn. Oh, walking one, this would be friends with this one. This one is overjoyed, but this one keeps the ways of weaving a secret. Even if walking one has learned the secret, walking one could not weave in the same way. Ooh, interesting. Alexia. I do like coming up there and reading the chat bubbles on these characters sometimes. Walking one has a sprite step. This one is amused. Teehee. But this one is still sleepy. Interesting. Sleepy. Wake up! I meet Elamida. How charming. You fit right in here in Little Solace. Be forewarned, though, such pleasantries will get you nowhere with the sylphs who dwell in the homeland. Magnificent. You have an excellent ambassador to Little Solace, friend. Mind you, not all sylphs are welcoming of outsiders, and woodland spires would gut you before your feet even off the ground. That don't sound fun. Ah, this walking one is dancing one. This one is always happy to see dancing ones. Oh, Lord. Last one. Boy, are my legs tired. Well, mine aren't. I bet Mana's are, though. Walking one is a friend to one. These ones are friendly, like gracious elder one of Forest City. Knows how to dance in these ones' hearts. Alright, so let's go talk. Who are we gonna go talk to now? Ida. You gotta go. Ida didn't help. She said she would. Mana, would you like to hear good news? Or the better news? Good news is that your lovely dance has brought the smiles and high hopes to all of the Little Solace. Better news is while through the recovery of those cursed leg cramps, onward to our next pair. Her leg's not hurting anymore. That's better news. Yeah. Oh God! All right, guys. This is a rather lengthy storyline, and I think I'm actually going to end this here. I want to thank you guys for watching, and please do like, favorite, and subscribe for the videos. If you want to see more, leave a comment down below, and I will see you guys next time. Take care and good night.